Hi guys. Today I will talk about the very mysterious Longyou Caves, created over 2,000 years ago. There were no historical records until Chinese farmers discovered them in 1992. I believe these caves were machine-made by an advanced ancient civilization. In this video, I will focus on the cave's oversized stairs and their intriguing tool marks. Located near a village in Zhejiang Province, southern China, lies the Longyou Caves, an extensive and magnificent world. So far, 45 caves have been discovered and 36 have been excavated. It's one of the largest underground excavations, which involved the removal of almost a million cubic meter of stone. That's about 42% of the volume of the Great Pyramid of Giza. Longyou Cave is not the only such cave system. There is another site just like Longyou Caves, which is 26 miles away, and maybe even bigger. These two cave systems share the exact same tool marks with similar characteristics. Why aren't these caves found earlier? Let me show you what they look like from the ground level. The small pond is an entrance to a cave. Pretty good disguise, right? The only clue that give it away is the sharply cut pillar here. These caves were filled with water and stayed hidden for thousands of years until modern-day pumps came along to drain them. Some caves at Longyou still have a lot of mud on the bottom, as deep as 5 to 8 meters or 16 to 26 feet. Once all that mud is removed, who knows what remains to be found? Back to our topic. Longyou caves are massive. The average cave floor area is over 1,000 square meters, which is the size of an American football pitch. The caves have heights that soar up to 30 meters or equal to a 10-story building. The total floor area exceeds 30,000 square meters, which is equivalent to 30 American football pitches or 5 FIFA soccer fields. Truly an unbelievable construction. And there is no evidence of where the huge amount of original stone went, or signs of the workers' dwellings that went into this grand-scale excavation. Old caves have maintained their structural integrity for at least 2,000 years. None are interconnected. Here is a diagram showing what a cave looks like. With the help of modern equipment, we learn that the overall construction is extremely accurate and well-planned. The caves are adjacent to and within close proximity to each other. Some caves are placed on top of one another, and many caves are basically next door. The thickness of the neighboring walls are consistent. However, it varies from wall to wall. The thinnest walls are half a meter or 1.6 feet thick. I'm showing a 3D cave model. How did the builders achieve this continuous precision over 2,000 years ago? How did ancient people manage to do this? And for what purpose did these intricate caves serve? What were these sunken rectangular holes used for? The setup of these caves reveal an advanced engineering knowledge similar to today's remote sensing technology, which can see through densely forested regions. Pretty amazing. Here, I want to clarify two things. First, the reliefs on the walls and pillars are not original. The local people unfortunately made them of cement as tourist attractions after 1992. It's a pity that they damaged the original finish. And the arched tunnels that connected the caves are sadly new additions made by the locals for tourists. The appearance of the tool marks in the tunnels was fabricated by locals to match the original marks. Experts around the world have been baffled with the complexity and precision of the Longyou caves, prompting numerous questions that no one has been able to answer. Who built the Longyou caves? what kind of technology was employed during their construction? How did the builders remove and transport tons of carved out rock? A consensus is that whomever constructed Longyou Caves had advanced knowledge on par with today's technology.
One of the most interesting and challenging questions is how these caves were originally constructed. Today, I keep my hypothesis focusing on two subjects, the tumuls and the oversized stairs.
Each cave is covered from floor to ceiling with the same intriguing tumuls, a series of parallel bands about 60 centimeters or 2 feet wide. This scale of work would have required immense manpower and likely decades to create.
In my last video, I explained why it's impossible to believe these uniformed, large-scale stoneworks were made by hand tools such as chisels and pickaxes. Ancient sites such as Yangshan, Baalbek, and Petra all show thousands of year-old tool marks that match modern-day machine marks. Click here to watch the tool mark video. Now, I want to compare the Longyou marks with today's machine marks.
Here I compare a 19th to 20th century salt mine in Ukraine with Longyou Caves. See how similar the layers of parallel marks are. Here's another comparison of the same salt mine. Now I compare two marks created by modern rotary drum cutter with markings on Longyou Caves. The two marks are fairly identical. The marks created by the mining machines are very close to the two marks we see in the Longyou Caves. Also, Longyou Caves' two marks share similar traits with other ancient sites in both uniformity and scale of construction. These precise marks could not have been done by hand tools and clearly resemble machine marks. Even if you painted these marks on the walls, it wouldn't be as consistent, let alone carving them by hand on sandstone. Here is a video showing how a mining machine works. We can see the finished area have very similar marks to Longyou Caves. I believe Longyou Caves are another example of ancient stonework constructed by machines. Now let's discuss the stairs. To enter the caves, we need to go through a square opening about 20 square meters or 250 square feet from the ground. Between the opening and the top of the stair landing, there is a big elevation drop about 4 to 5 meters or 13 to 16 feet. It will be a very difficult entry for a human to use. Maybe wood or metal ladders were once used, but no such evidence was found. The original cave stairs are also not the same as today's stairs we use. The cave stairs are oversized with an average rise of 60 centimeters or 2 feet. That's 3.5 times higher than today's regular step rise. The steps are not flat but sloped and fairly steep, like a combination of current day stairs with slopes. Maybe they were built this way to help excavating the rocks. Since I'm proposing that the caves were constructed with machines, the cave entries and the stairs were possibly built for not only people, but also their large excavation machinery. Could the oversized stairs mean that the ancient people who constructed and used Longyou Caves were 3 times taller than today's average adults? Maybe in a future video, I might explore this theory or fantasy on whether 5 meter or 16 feet ancient giants once existed.
We can't answer the question how these incredible caves were constructed if we limit ourselves to the assumption they were made by hand tools and manual labor 2,000 years ago. If we look further than 6,000 years back, there remains the real possibility that advanced civilizations existed and used technology lost to time. We should open our minds and contemplate that prehistory civilizations used sophisticated machinery to build these unexplained grand sites, such as Longyou Caves and Yangshan Monument. By expanding our thought process, we adapt our ways of thinking and break the chains that prevent us from decoding what technology could have existed in the distant past. Often mysteries remain shrouded in clouds of ignorance and fear because investigators refuse to think outside the box. In my next video, I will discuss other mysterious topics about Longyou Caves, such as why there are deep sunken holes inside. If you like my video, please give me a thumbs up and subscribe. If you have any insights, please leave me a comment. I would love to hear from you. This is Curious Being. I'm Tina. Thanks for watching and see you next time.